Let's look at the solution to our two-way set associative cache quiz. As before, the answer to this type of question requires us to figure out which bits in the address determine what in the cache. So the address will be broken into offset, in this case 5 bits, index, in this case 2 bits to tell us which set we have, and the tag. 7 bits are used by the index and the offset, which means the index will be determined only by the least significant 2 digits. So now we can just figure out that 0003 is like this. 5 bits are the offset, the next 2 bits are the index. So this maps to set 0, and we will put F303 there. Next one is F503. It maps to the same set, but this set now has 2 places, so we can actually put F503 in the other line in that set. Next we have F563. 6-3 is like this. This maps to set number 3. And finally, EF63 is gonna map to the same set, and we'll put it here. So as you can see, with a two-way set associative cache, we can put more than one block that maps to the same place in the cache and not have conflicts. This is why we want to have a two-way cache or more, because it reduces the number of conflicts. However, it complicates the tag checks, because now when we're looking for something, we have 2 places to search before we're sure whether it's there or not.